Hey guys, welcome to Natural Aesthetics. So I recently received a request to do a video on why I'm still natural, so I thought I'd take the time today to address that subject. So I've never taken any steroids before, any performance enhancing drugs, any hormones, pro-hormones, anything of that nature. Never felt the need to do it. Since 2014, I haven't touched any caffeine or pre-workouts or any bodybuilding supplements really. I sometimes take some health-orientated supplements, and I use a vegan protein powder. I just like relying on food, mental strength, and training. Just keep it simple. So in 2014, I suffered from some nerve inflammation, which really set me back. It was horrendous. So my gut feeling was at that time that it was from a pre-workout supplement. So obviously since then, I've cut out all those kind of bodybuilding supplements. So when I was younger, I kind of, I guess, thought about steroids when I first kind of found out about them, but it was just mild curiosity, really. How big could I get on the steroids? How would I look compared to other guys on steroids? Knowing that I've achieved so much already as a natural, you know, what could I achieve on top of that? But it kind of passed really quickly, and it was never really serious enough to, you know, find out how to attain steroids or really do any research on it. It just didn't tempt me. I'm still not tempted by it now, and I don't think I'll ever take steroids in the future. It was never the health issues or side effects that put me off. It was just the fact that I knew it would make it easier to build muscle. And I don't know why, for some reason, it just doesn't do it for me. I like the idea of working very hard for long periods of time to achieve small gains, albeit very, very rewarding gains, because you know how much work you've had to do to get that. That really motivates me and inspires me to continue training. Honestly, you could offer me a pill that, you know, would put on 20 kilos of muscle in the next 2 years and I'd have no side effects from that. I would turn it down. That's just not me. I don't know why. It's just not the way I'm wired. It never has been. It never will. Some people aren't like that. You know, I've trained people that aren't like that, and you know, they're less patient. All power to them. Everyone's different, but it's just not me. It's just not the way I'm wired. And I kind of like the fact that, you know, from a fairly young age, when I first started to get into natural bodybuilding, you know, I've been training for fitness and stuff, and then I started training in a gym, and you know, found out about natural bodybuilding. I just kind of got stuck on that idea of being a natural bodybuilder and showing myself and everyone around me that I could achieve a very muscular physique and become very strong without taking any of these supplements or drugs that everyone around me said that you had to take. You know, you have to take that. You can't achieve anything without it. You're not going to be able to do this. You're not going to be able to do that with this compound. And for me, that just really, really motivated me. For most people, the physique they want to achieve, you don't need to take steroids. That's a harsh reality. Steroids are massively, massively overused. I'd say 80% of people, maybe even more, shouldn't be taking steroids, because the physique they actually want to attain is attainable without any drugs. It's attainable with a few years of hard work as a natural. I kind of envisioned what I wanted to look like as well when I first started to get into bodybuilding. And, you know, I'm still nowhere near that, but I'm a hell of a lot closer than I was, say, 10 years ago. I'm getting there. I'm really pleased with that I've achieved a decent level of muscularity. You know, over the years, I've been strong in certain areas. Of course, that goes up and down. You know, I've achieved a lot. I've done a few competitions, and I thought I looked really good in some of them. I still want to do a lot more competing and stuff. I honestly feel like I'm just getting started as a natural bodybuilder. If I was an IFBB guy, then I don't think I'd be saying that. I think the lifespan of top IFBB guys is generally much shorter. In some guys, not all, but generally speaking, their physique seem to decline a lot quicker aesthetically than it would do if you were natural. You know, top naturals seem to peak maybe 10 to 15, maybe even 20 years later than an IFBB guy would. And I think that's just down to the heavy drugs they're using. You know, not necessarily the steroids, the hormones, the growth hormone, the insulin, stuff like that. You know, now I certainly don't regret not taking steroids, because I feel like I'm in such a small minority. You know, I'm really almost unusual, which is terrible, really. It shouldn't be like that, but it is. You know, there's definitely a hell of a lot more guys taking steroids that are as muscular as me than there are natural guys. So, you know, I'm in a very small minority as a natural bodybuilder, which, you know, makes me feel good. It makes me feel quite proud that I've kind of stuck with it for so long. I feel like if I were to take steroids now, then I'd just be like everyone else. I'd just be like every other gym rat. You know, I'm sure I'd be a lot bigger and a lot stronger, but, you know, what would I do if I was still competing? I'd still need to aspire to that top level, to that, you know, top IFBB level, which I think is unattainable. As much as I find it interesting, you know, who's doing what competition and who's winning what, it's interesting to see how much muscle they can put on their frames. It really doesn't inspire me to kind of follow in their footsteps. Whereas when I look at a top natural guy, that motivates me, because although it's still a massive jump in muscularity, for me, it's kind of attainable. It feels like there's hope to be able to get to that level. And also, in my eyes, looks better. The guys are generally leaner and have more striations in their upper body. I just generally think they look better. It's obviously more aesthetic. Now, I'll save that conversation for another video. I'd like to talk about that, actually, the difference in the physiques and the kind of lifespan of the bodybuilders and what's causing that. There's been a massive decline lately in the IFBB guys, but yeah, that's another subject. So for me now, basically, you know, if I were to take steroids and if I still wanted to compete, that top pinnacle that I'd be aiming at would be just unreachable for me. I really think it would, you know. Whereas if I wanted to compete at the top level in natural bodybuilding, I think I can do it. I know I can do it. It just takes patience, you know, and I'm then not reliant on anything else. I'm not reliant on these drugs and these drug protocols to achieve what I want to achieve. You know, the body can achieve such amazing things, and I think it's a real shame that people don't realise and don't get to see what the body is capable of without these compounds, without these drugs and stuff. So thanks for watching, guys. If you enjoyed the video, if it motivated you, then give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to see more. Check out my social media. The links are in the description box below. And I'll see you in the next video. Stay strong.